So this is a video in this series on the chakra energies and how we can use the information that our chakras provide us to help guide our students and our athletes toward more balanced energies in their body so that they're at optimal performance level. So what you're hearing in the background is 596 hertz frequency. This is the frequency of the solar plexus chakra. On YouTube, you'll find all kinds of videos to balance the solar plexus chakra. The location of the solar plexus chakra, and I like to lift mine just a little bit above the navel, but it's somewhere between where your ribs come together right there and your belly button. It's between that space. It's a golden yellow disc or globe that spins within you. You do have a front solar plexus and a back solar plexus. So these two energies in the front and the back help to keep you centered right in the now moment. Releasing things that happened that affected your solar plexus in the back by the spinning of this chakra energy in meditation, and then the moving forward and allowing this brightness to balance out with the other two chakras underneath are what keep us balanced and centered in this chakra, okay? So the solar plexus in Sanskrit is known as the Mandy Pruett, which is the jewel city chakra. The drive for the solar plexus is willpower. So this is where our will to survive and to create, to use the resources for survival, to create something that is uniquely ours, and the willpower to move it into a place of uniqueness to you. Okay, the color, like I said, of the solar plexus chakra is yellow, and you think obviously it's solar, the sun is yellow, so it's our sense of sun. Yeah, it's our solar plexus, yeah. And the physical body, some of the different functions that the solar plexus oversees are the abdomen, the digestive system, the lower and the middle back. So it has a lot to do with where in the body this is, okay? So the digestive system is very, very, as research has been showing us, the gut is your third brain. So we have three brains in our body, one being in our mind, the second being right here, and the third being down here, okay? With the heart being the strongest of the three, okay? And understanding how these three minds work together, we'll talk about that in later videos. But that is the function in the physical body, some of the places in our body where the solar plexus oversees the abdomen, digestive system, and the lower and middle back. I do a lot of work when we do our technique classes and our warm-up on how to use breath work to balance the solar plexus. Yeah, and I use some breath of fire. It's called breath of fire or Kapalabhati to balance this. There's a couple other breathing techniques, Bastrika, that will help to balance the energy here. And then a third called Agnisara. But we'll do other videos on that, okay? The element of the solar plexus, if the sun is this giant gaseous ball of fire, then the element that oversees the solar plexus is fire. This is our will, that passion, that drive. So the solar plexus is our element of fire, yeah? The sense of our five senses that the solar plexus oversees is our sight, okay? So we do, this is where, you know, physical attraction comes from the solar plexus. And as you go up your chakras, that becomes less important and you see more from the soul aspect. But the solar plexus is the place in our body where physical attraction is important. Okay. Some of the crystals that you can use to help balance your solar plexus are the yellow citrine, the topaz, yellow topaz. So you can take your crystals, charge them in the sun, charge them in the full moon, and help them to be strong enough that when you wear them, you receive the full capacity of benefits from those chakras, from that energy, from those stones, okay? Some oils that are associated with the solar plexus are bergamot. That's the scent that I love to wear. It's very, very lovely citrusy scent. And then ylang ylang, okay? So those scents and essential oils are wonderful balancing for the solar plexus. The animal associated with the solar plexus is the ram, a very powerful, strong animal. And then in terms of planets that oversee the chakra, the sun and Mars. And Mars is a planet of action. It's the planet of the divine masculine. It is also the planet of sometimes conflict. So really making sure that the solar plexus is balanced so that you can use the Mars energy to a positive benefit is very, very helpful. So how do we balance, and how do you determine and understand if the solar plexus is overactive, underactive, or in balance in your students? Okay, so an overactive solar plexus will be incredibly judgmental. They're very stubborn, they're incredibly critical, and they can sometimes be the bully. So really finding out and recognizing if you've got students who are acting in a way that's not quite of their highest character is a great indicator of the solar plexus. And the solar plexus does also oversee the nervous system, your gallbladder, and things like this. So your nervous system plays a huge role in the functionality of your solar plexus. This is where you often see arrogance popping up. And so it's very, very important to recognize, especially in a sport that is demanding as cheer and performance cheer. It is an incredibly demanding sport, not only because it's incredibly physically impactful on our bodies, physically in terms of the kind of fitness level you need to be in order to do the sport well, but also physically in terms of outward appearance. So our outward, like being a cheerleader and being a performance cheer athlete, it's not a secret that we, in order to be a part of this sport, there is an element of physical appearance that goes into it, and we cannot deny that. We have to recognize that being in this sport means that you're an attractive person, and not only attractive in how you look, but how you are, your character, the person that you are. And if we spend our time competing against one another and not recognizing the art of competition as showing up as your best self, your most authentic self, in a place of grounded beauty of who you are, then we are missing the point. We are missing the opportunity of how we can be very impactful in the world. So it's so important that we see this sport and we see how easily it is to pass judgment when you are among an athlete in a sport that recognizes physical beauty. How easily it is judged by those who don't understand. And I know this firsthand, my friends. Be more of that. Shine your light. Shine your light in a grounded, honest, creative sense of who you are. Okay? And please recognize that an overactive solar plexus in this industry is a dangerous, dangerous thing. Okay? And I cannot stress that enough. An underactive solar plexus has very low self-esteem. They procrastinate, they're apathetic. They just don't really care about things. And they feel taken advantage of quite a bit. And a balanced solar plexus has deep respect for themselves and for others. They're very confident. They're calm in the face of adversity. And they are a problem solver by nature, okay? Or by balance, okay? By the ability to balance and not allow that chakra to be too overactive or too underactive, but just to be in perfect balance, okay? So, some of the foods that you can eat that will help balance the solar plexus: bananas, yellow squash, spaghetti squash. Those foods are wonderful balancing for the solar plexus. And like I said, listening to the meditations at the frequency of the solar plexus will help to balance that energy. So I hope this was helpful. Please like and subscribe and pay it forward by sharing this with someone else that you love. Maybe share it with a family member, share it with a coworker, that we're in this together. It's time to shine ourselves and shine our light as a rainbow of beauty, grace, and wisdom. Namaha.